What's going on? It's your brother X, and I am back to do another video for you guys. And in this video, we're going to be talking about, are all these beard routines necessary, or is it all just overrated? Okay, so I'm outside. Decided I want to switch it up a little bit, give you guys a little bit different scenery. It is a little bit hot, so I'm going to try and get this done and get it out of the way as soon as possible so that I can go hang out in the shade somewhere and chill out for the rest of the evening. All right, so this is a topic that I've been getting asked quite a bit. There have been some comments on some videos regarding, are all these necessary, are all these steps and routines necessary for beard care, or is it all just unnecessary garbage? All right, so let's go ahead and dive into it, and I'm gonna give you guys my top three reasons why the routines that I show you guys on my channel are definitely a necessary step in the process. Now, for some of you guys, you may not need to do any of the routines that I talk about, and I'm gonna explain to you why that may be too. So stick with me, go ahead and tap the subscribe button, tap the bell so you get notified every time I drop a video, and let's go ahead and jump right on into it. Okay, so the first thing we gotta talk about is, does beard size impact your beard care routines? All right, so is there a difference when you're growing a bigger beard or when your beard is bigger than when it is smaller? And my answer to that is definitely yes. And I'm gonna tell you guys some of the reasons. First of all, when your beard is starting to get longer, okay, as it starts to get farther from the skin, there's a lot of different things that go into play that's gonna impact your beard care, your beard health, and all of that. Okay, so the longer your beard gets, the more abuse it receives, the more changes in temperature it receives, the more abrasion from styling routines and different combs and brushes and whatever else you use, the more damage it receives from just your normal everyday routines, whether it be going to the beach, swimming in pools on a regular basis, whether it be working in dusty, dirty environments and you have to wash your beard more often. So the longer your beard gets, the more abuse that it takes. And some people say, well, what about people with short beards? They do the same things. Yes, they might do those same things, but they probably, if they keep their beard maintained at a shorter length, every 2 weeks, 3 weeks, whatever the case may be, they're going to the barber or doing it themselves, and they're cutting their beard back down to the normal length. So that's taking off a lot of the damage. So the longer your beard gets, the longer the hairs get, the damage here, the older hair is at the tips. The fresh, new, young growth is closer to the skin. So that older hair is constantly getting cut off, and you don't have to deal with a lot of the problems. So your beard hairs don't have to go through a lot of the things that longer beard hairs have been through. Those long beard hairs have been through some battles, you know what I mean? So constantly cutting your beard hairs off, if you have a shorter beard, you can get away with not doing a lot of the routines. And this all depends on your beard textures as well. So I don't want to broad brush and give you guys, you know, one solid answer. This works for everybody, because it definitely doesn't. A lot of beards are different. They have their different variations of beards, different variations of beard textures. So there are differences in the way you have to care for your beard. And only you know your beard texture. For the shorter beards, does that mean now that you don't have to do any routines? Absolutely not, because you still want to keep healthy skin beneath your beard. You still want your beard to look vibrant and healthy. You don't want to have even a short beard, you don't want it to look unhealthy. So while you may not have to do steps, like if you keep your beard very short, quarter an inch, or use a number one guard, whatever the case may be, you may not need to do deep conditions. So that's a routine you can skip. But if you have a larger beard, or you're trying to grow a larger beard, so you want to keep those hairs healthy at all times, because you know that short hair is eventually going to be long, and that beard hair is going to be, it's going to be a lot older. It's going to have to go months and months, sometimes even years, to get to that length. You want to make sure you baby and you take care of and you nourish and you maintain that beard hair, so it has a really good chance not only of getting to that length, but when it gets there, it's healthy, so you don't have to start trimming off split ends. You don't have to start cutting off a lot of single strand knots and things like that. Now, another thing when it comes to the length of your beard and doing a lot of these steps and routines, the longer your beard, the harder it is for your skin's natural sebum oil to get from your skin to the tip of your beard hairs, especially if you have a really curly beard. So there are a lot of brothers out there that have beards that aren't as curly, okay? And when you have a beard that's not as curly, gravity will help take that sebum oil from your skin to the tip of your beard. Now, if your beard hairs are going like this, and curling up and down. I have hairs that go down and they curl up and they're all over the place. That sebum oil is gonna hit that curve and it's not gonna go back up to nourish the rest of the hair. It's gonna sit right there. So the later ends of your beard, the later tips of your beard aren't going to be as nourished. Pardon me, I'm outside, so you know, you gotta deal with that. So the later tips of your beard hairs aren't going to get that natural sebum oil. So you have to supplement that with different routines. You have to supplement that with different oils and with different things that you use to make sure your beard care is on point. Another thing when deciding, do you have to do all these routines, is know your plans. So if you never have a plan of growing a really huge beard, you can slack on some of them routines if you know next week, hey, I'm gonna be cutting all this off. My new fresh growth is gonna be new, as long as you're keeping your skin healthy, because you don't wanna have flakes in your beard because you're keeping your skin dry. You still want your growth to be healthy. You don't wanna end up with patches in your beard because you're not keeping your skin as healthy as possible. So there's things you wanna do, and you wanna maintain a healthy routine and a healthy regimen just to make sure that no matter what length you decide to keep the beard at, it's gonna be a healthy beard. So now, if you know ahead of time you want your beard to grow long and you have these goals, you can't slack in the beginning and then later on think you're gonna get to that place, because you're gonna end up with a lot more single strand knots. If you're not taking the time to comb at the right time and you're combing a dry beard and you're messing with your beard with your hands and you're creating knots where the hairs are tangling together, or you're getting a lot of split ends and you have to cut your split ends off, it's because your preparation is not right, and preparation is key. So if you know you're gonna grow a longer beard, you're gonna wanna start doing a lot of the routines I talk about, depending on your texture, of course. You may need, if you have a curly, coarse beard, you're gonna need morning routines. You're gonna need nighttime routines. You're gonna wanna mix in a deep condition. And also, if you have certain things you do in your lifestyle. So if you're constantly going to the gym, which means you have to wash your beard more than usual, or if you're constantly going to the beach this time of year and you're swimming in salt water or you're swimming in chlorine, you're gonna need to do steps to get your skin and your beard back nourished. You're gonna wanna put that moisture back in your beard. So you're gonna have to do a lot of these routines. And if you're slacking, you're not gonna get to the goals you wanna get to, all right? So I just wanna let y'all know, yes, I believe these routines are important, but if you're gonna keep a shorter, more small, maintained beard, you probably can get away with not doing a lot of them. All right, it's your brother X. I gotta go ahead and get out of this sun. I'm burning up, you know what I mean? But yo, anything for my people. So man, I appreciate all of y'all. Continue to like, continue to share, continue to subscribe to the channel. I'll be back at y'all again soon, all right? Peace.